and welcome to the newspaper review on Tab TV. My name is Sophie John, your host for today. In case you're just joining us and you're wondering what the show is all about, it's a show where we get to look at news stories making the front page of Nigerian newspaper. We get to talk about them here and dissect them. And of course, I won't be doing this alone. I'm joined by a very amazing lady, and that's my cozy. Welcome.
Ah, thank you.
You look so beautiful today.
Oh, you look so beautiful too.
I must compliment you each time.
Always, always. It's as if it's not a norm of me.
You will tell us the secret to this beauty one of those days.
It's God. It's as if it's a norm of mine that whenever I come, I look forward to your compliments.
Alright, without no further ado, we head over to our first newspaper for the day. We'll be looking at the Daily Trust newspaper, and its leading will never be overwhelmed. That's according to CJN, that's the Chief Justice of Nigeria. Sub story under that, judges must avoid embarrassing judiciary, and that's according to Yadudu. Court deciding election winners bad for polity. And that's according to PDP elders, and you can read that up on page 11 of the Daily Trust newspaper. FEC raises 2024 budget as Tinubu present 27.5 trillion naira tomorrow, and that's on page 19 of the newspaper. Fresh protest hits Kano over governorship dispute as police arrest seven, and you can read that up on page 10 of the Daily Trust newspaper. Tinubu reappoints Kyari as NNPCL GCEO, names Akinyeolore board chair, and that's according to the Daily Trust newspaper on page 1 of that paper. State LGS cries for development despite sharing 88.8 trillion naira in 2 years. And you can read that up on page 4 of the Daily Trust, and that's all we'll be taking on the Daily Trust newspaper. I would like your view on the story on page 11. FEC raises 2024 budget as Tinubu presents 27.5 trillion naira tomorrow. I like your thoughts on that.
I don't know whether I should say it's a good one or a bad one, because I remember when they first brought out the first 2024 budget, which was estimated to be 26.1 million trillion actually. A lot of persons criticized it because we felt it was so exorbitant and it was extravagant.
Yeah.
And the fact that the government said that we inherited a very bad, government. And all the revenue they are getting, they are being paying off their debts and all that. So for a government that actually claimed that they inherited a bad government, I feel the right thing they should have done is to cut their quota according to their star size. Okay. You understand? Because it's just like if I have something like 10,000 naira and I want to go to the market and that's all I have on me, I can't buy something that will exceed that 10,000. I'll have to, if I want to buy a pack of tomato, I'll have to cut it. Either I buy half because I have other things I want to buy. You understand? I can't just say because I have 10,000 there, let me buy more. I'll end up not buying the things that are relevant. You understand? So this is how the government looks like. The money they are generating is not even up to the budget they made, and now they increased it. So how are they planning to generate this fund if not by borrowing? And they already approved to borrow 7.8 trillion at whose expense? At the country's expense. And the money they're also spending, it's more than what we are getting. How can your expenditure be more than your income? It's not possible. You continue to go deeper. And they made some plans, they promised that with this, that they are going to cut down some cut down the inflation rate, which is 27.3% to 21%. And how are they going to go about it? I don't know if these governments are just making empty promises, if they are just saying it just because they want to say it. Because at the end of the time, if they can't meet it or meet up with it, all they can say is they did their best. Just because they are not too, they cannot be held accountable if anything should happen. It's as if they just wake up. All they want to just give us fake hope, which is very wrong for a government or for a country that is developing or claim that they are developing. Because the policies they are making is too much. It's too much at whose expense? We are making good policies. And the main purpose of making a policy is for you to push towards it. Like, let me say we're entering 2024 and you want to reach your goal at a particular time, maybe in 3 months' time.
You said something about the blame game in our administration, because over the weekend, the former governor of the CBN and present governor of Anambra State came out to say that Tinubu inherited a bad government, and he's giving kudos to Tinubu for the innovations he have made during this time, despite the almost comatose government he inherited, despite the innovations he have made. It's really something to applaud for. So my question is, do you see the policies our president is making, do you see it affecting Nigeria in a negative or a positive way presently? Because we have heard a lot from the president, a lot of him setting up the committee for taxes, trying to reduce tax on the citizens. He also brought about the palliative, although we have not heard much about the palliative. There are a lot of things he has been trying to put into place to make the government better. He even said when he went for the G20 summit, he said he deserved a Guinness Book of Record for the innovations he has been able to make.
I think I have to answer this question with a question. So far, so good. All those policies, what has or how has it impacted on Nigeria? How has it impacted on the economy? What happened? The inflation rate skyrocketed. The day he came in, the day he was inaugurated, that he said he is cutting off subsidies. That was the beginning of Nigerians' problem, this era. That was when everything started skyrocketing. Everything started hiking. Price of food, fuel, all of them started going. Even the naira. All the policies he has made has done little or nothing to the economy. It's as if you are just going round. You are just going round. You talked about the palliative policies, and I always say it, and I'll also say it here, that palliative policy is just another form of higher looting. If you can't teach people how to fish, giving them fish to make them come back again. And yes, the president said he has done his part. It's left for he has given them their own palliative share and all that. Because I remember he brought out 500 billion and he said that estates is entitled to collect 5 billion. And some states came out that time to say they only collected 2 billion. Why some local governments, some citizens, some Nigerians came out to say that all they went home with was 5 cups of rice? What would 5 cups of rice do to a family of 4, a family of 6? Are you just giving them so that it will quench their hunger at that moment? In terms of, I don't know about us, how it has kind of affected the economy, but the fact that the inflation rate is still 27.33% shows that nothing has been done about it. You understand? And he promised that by December this year that the refinery will start working, but still nothing has been heard. Like I said earlier, that the palliative, sorry, not the palliative, but actually the policies the government are making, it's not really, it's to me, it's just, you know, I don't know the scenario that I'm going to use it, but it's just like, you have to do this. It's a norm, you need to, else they'll think you're not working. That's what the government are doing here. Because they know that even if they don't fulfill it, they can't be held accountable. The problem Nigeria has is lack of accountability. You need to account for, you need, they need to be holding the government responsible for every word they say. You want to do this, then do it. Don't come out again to say, I want to do this one, forgetting the other one you did, you said. That's because of the lack of accountability, lack of principles. A principled person always is always true to his word, no matter what, because he knows that once he says it, he's going to do it definitely. No matter the hardship, no matter the hurdles that he experienced, because he is principled. Most Nigerian government officials, they are not principled. They just came out to open their mouth to say anything so that they will feel or do make the people, make, there's something called make believe. You need to feel that I'm working. Now they said they are going to reduce the inflation rate by next year, and we are still watching. When they mentioned, when he said he's going to look into the refinery, Port Harcourt refinery, that he's going to reduce it and all that, I told you something. I said it's not possible. Something that they started working on since 2015, out of the blues. Like the first lady said, Remy Tinubu, he said, she said that her husband is not a magician. But the fact that they make promises like magicians, you understand? Are you not saying that we Nigerians, because we accept anything that is being thrown at us, so it's none of their business. They can come out to say, what are you even saying? During their campaign, they came out to make a lot of manifestos, a lot of empty promises that this government is normal, it's worse, as if, I don't know how I'm going to say, tell you this, that this government, they are taking Nigerians as for a mickey. They don't care. And the fact that each government that comes in don't care about the interests of the citizen will continue to make Nigeria to go down. You can't do this in a developed country. You can't just come out to say that you are doing this and you don't fulfill it. Because if you are coming out next day, you'll be held accountable. You'll be held accountable for everything that happens. So that's what Nigerian government policies is. It's like, it's just full of empty promises. And if they continue like that, it's going to go down. I won't be surprised if this inflation rate still increase. I won't be surprised. They even promised that dollar now will be $1 to $7.50, right? Let's see how it goes.
All right, let's see how everything plays out. We move over to our next newspaper of the day. We'll be looking at the Vanguard newspaper. And it's leading, "We can't replace law with emotions." That's according to the Chief Justice of Nigeria. I think he's finally breaking his silence after the judiciary judgment. Let me just call it the judiciary from the appeal court to the Supreme Court. He's breaking his silence after that. You can find that all on page 5 of the newspaper. "Judicial decisions can affect FDI." That's according to CBN Governor. And you can read that up on page 37 of the Vanguard newspaper. "FD jacks up 2024 budget to 27.5 trillion naira. And that's on page 9 of the newspaper. "Tinubu reappoints Kyari Group CEO of NNPC." And that's on page 13 of the newspaper. "Appeal court judgment, protest rocks part of Kanu." And that's on page 13 of the Vanguard. "Appeal court says Kaduna's speaker orders return in 5 polling units." And that's on page 13 of the newspaper. "FEC votes 3.23 billion naira for explosive narcotics detection scanners in 5 airports." And that's on page 8 of the newspaper. And that's all we'll be talking about on the Vanguard newspaper. I would also like to comment on a picture on the cover page of the Vanguard that shows the Oba of Benin in Lagos. It's a picture of the governor of Lagos, Sanwo Olu, welcoming the Oba of Benin. I feel this visit is really a very impressive one, because over the weekend we had, I think it was over the weekend or during the week, that was last week, we had the Anambra State Governor, that Soludo, welcome some Oba of Yoruba land into the government house. I think it's a welcome development. If we want to fight tribalism, we have to see all these our traditional leaders,
exactly,
respected figures, visit all the state government. That is merging a lot of things, merging government with the grassroots. It means
exactly
a lot. This type of visits are more welcome. I want to see more of this. I want to see more of this visit. All right, back to the newspaper. I would like your thoughts on the story on page 5. We can't replace law with emotions. That's according to the Chief Justice of Nigeria. We can't replace laws with emotions.
It's the statement, I feel it explains itself, right?
Yes.
It's not possible for them to use sentiments. You need to prove your case beyond reasonable doubt that this is what happened. They work with facts and not emotions. You understand? You need to, no matter what happened, if they say you kill someone, you have to prove it beyond reasonable doubt. But it's quite unfortunate that some persons in the judiciary system, they have sold their soul to the devil by collecting bribes at the expense of the poor masses, right? I'm not saying all of them, but according to the Chief Justice of Nigeria, he said that that the reason why they're having all these things that is happening, all these things that is happening in different states, how the judiciary are handling it and all that, that the reason is that some persons have, they are collecting bribe, you understand? And not just because they are collecting bribe, but they cannot freely speak because of fear of some certain person, you understand? And since the judiciary, that they are not autonomous, they want to be autonomous. If you remembered at the beginning of this year, that they came out protesting, that they want to be truly independent. Independent judiciary, that's, they need to be without any fear of or being harassed or being...
Without the president appointing the Chief Justice.
Exactly, without any fear of delivering their judgment, without any being harassed or anything, that they need that stationary protection. That if that the constitution, the 1999 constitution, has to be reviewed, and the judiciary has to be given that paramount power to deliver their judgment without any fear of the federal interference or the state interference. You understand? Because the reason why most of these judges delivered wrongly is because of fear of being harassed.
Who pays the piper?
The taste, the tone. You understand? So, according to him, so he's saying that the judiciary has to be given independence. They need to be autonomous to be able to deliver their judgment. And if you look at what happened, because of the thing that he actually made this statement during the swearing in of 58 sons, you understand? So he said that a lot of persons are not happy about their judgments, that a lot of persons came out protesting and all that. And it can be seen during the time of, after the elections, the governorship and presidential election, a lot of things happened because a lot of parties had to appeal their case. Even some went to the Supreme Court when it didn't favor them. You understand? And look at what is happening recently in Kano State, where they found out that they have two citizens that are certified true copy. They found out that they have two, and each bears different name. the winner, the first one has the name of the former governor of Kano, that's Abba Yusuf. So you see that, why the other one has the name of this recent,
the new governor.
Exactly. So you see that those things, it has made people not to have faith in the judiciary system. Because they say the judiciary is the last hope for the common man. But look at what's happening. With all this happening in a country that claims they are developing, do you think that tomorrow someone will want to appeal their case? Because they already know whose side the judges will side on. If you don't pay more, your case won't be heard. If you are not rich, your case won't be heard. Where is the statement that it's the judiciary is the last hope of the common man? What is the assurance? You understand? The duty of the judges or the judiciary is to interpret the law. But with what's happening, Nigeria is not practicing the writing the claim. You see some instances where the judges or where the judge will give a verdict. But some persons, look at the instance of MFLA, the former CBN governor, where the judge gave them a specific an ultimatum that they should release MFLA on a belt of 200 million. But they still held him hostage. And you've seen the cases where the judge, no matter what they deliver, their final verdict and all that, they are seen as toothless bulldogs. What is the law that states that the rule of law is the absolute, that it's above everybody. Nobody is above the law. Where is that law? No, people don't regard the rule of law. They don't regard the law. As long as you have the money, you can buy your way in. How are we going to grow? How are we going to come out from these shackles if we keep on collecting bribe? If the judiciary system keep on going down like this, if they keep on being under the federal system. Yes, there's something called shakes and balances. They can't give them the whole power. But appointing a chief justice, to me, I feel is a way of limiting them from carrying out their duties. So the 1999 constitution should be reviewed. So that's my own here.
All right, we're going to show.
Hey there. Are you looking to record your videos, do your voiceovers, and take your professional pictures? Look no further. With our state-of-the-art newsroom, photography, kitchen for our food content creators, and exclusive children's studio, we certainly can deliver the best studio experience. Our carefully designed studio space can bring your diverse creative content ideas to life. We aim to consistently serve value to our customers far and wide. Come, let Tharv Media give life to your dreams. Tharv Media, a slice of infotainment.
Welcome back. We'll take our last newspaper of the day. We'll be looking at the Nigerian News Direct. And its leading fact pegs $77.96 crude benchmark, 750 naira per dollar exchange rate for 2024 appropriation bill. And you can read that up on page 2 of the newspaper. PDP heads the Supreme Court to challenge Sanwo-Olu's victory. And that's on page 7 of the Nigerian News Direct. Zenith Bank signs MOU with French government to establish operations in France. And that's on page 2 of the Nigerian News Direct. That's truly a great development. Zenith Bank signing an MOU.
Mm-hmm.
That's expanding the Nigerian business.
Business.
Despite police ban, protest rocks Kano over appeal court judgment. And that's on page 4 of the newspaper. Aviation minister blame poor regulatory oversight for frequent air accident meets with heads of agencies. And that's on page 24 of the newspaper. Edo 2024, I have been pressed but not crushed, persecuted but not abandoned. That's according to the Edo deputy governor, Shaibu. And that's on page 2 of the Nigerian News Direct, and that's all we're taking on the newspaper. Of course, you'll like your thought on the story on page 4. Despite police ban, protest rocks TANU over appeal court judgment. They won't stop protesting.
I love their spirit, right? I love that spirit because as of last week, some persons were, about 7 persons were actually arrested. And I don't know when the law states that there's no freedom for to protest, actually. There's no freedom to protest, to air out your view. There's freedom to speech. You have the right to protest as long as it's done in a peaceful way. You understand? Some correspondents in News Direct, they went, and according to them, they said that they are some marketers, and they said that they came out, some protestants, they came out 11 o'clock yesterday, and as they were protesting that, the police came and dispersed everybody, told everybody to go and all that. So my own question now, according to the marketer, he said that the protest was actually peaceful. There was nothing like violence means or anything. That the police just came and dismissed everybody. And they carried Yusuf flag, picture, and they are saying they should give them their mandate. That the kind of people voted for ABBA to come for the second tenure because he was the former governor. But just all of a sudden, they put in the APC man. I don't know whether it's a party team, you understand? But the fact that they voted for them, the law, they should review it. And the fact that they saw 2 CTC copy, they should review it. I think it should be reviewed and it should be properly managed because there's a way violence spreads to other states if not properly managed. You understand? So I just feel the way the police are going about it is not the right way to do it. This, the police, they are the people that they protect the rights of the citizen. You understand? Like in UK, you cannot, as long as you come out doing it peacefully, the police, there will even be a police that will come there to protect the rights of the protestants. That's how civilized the place is. When would this thing happen in Nigeria? Instead, the police, what they will have to do is to disperse everybody. Dispersing them, is that the right thing to do? The last time they dispatched them, now they came again and dispatched them just like that. Why? They have every right. We are not in a militant regime.
A military regime.
You understand? We are not in a military regime for them to just be acting anyhow with the civilians. And these people, they are unarmed. And to think that we've seen so many cases where the police, instead of protecting the rights of the citizen, they actually being killed. Like what happened in 2020 NSAS, where a lot of innocent unarmed citizens were being killed. So I just feel that for this not to spread to other states, they should manage it properly. They should review that CTC work. And the judges, they should make the right decision. Because for them to come out, the APC, they said the people that came out are NNPP supporters. You understand? Which is right. If you feel your mandate is being taken away from you, protest for it. As long as it's done peaceful. I'm emphasizing on that peaceful because that's the only way it can be legit. You understand? As long as you're not destroying any property, you're not disrupting the serenity of the state, it's okay. So I'm against them being arrested.
Whatever protest has to be done in a peaceful manner. We have the right to protest in a democratic system of government as far as it's always peaceful. All right, that's where we draw our curtains for today. It was really a great time on the newspaper review on Tap TV. I still remain your host, Sophia John, and I didn't do this alone. I was joined by Cozy. Remember to connect and engage with us on all our social media platforms. Like, subscribe, and comment on the video. Till we meet again tomorrow, stay safe.